Hey everyone, Larry Chen here. I'm a car culture and automotive photographer. I'm also a Canon Explorer of Light. I'm here today at my garage to show you my gear bag. I'm gonna start off with my main bodies that I use for car photography. These are Canon EOS 1DX Mark III cameras. And I actually have three of them. I use three of them because one usually is on a wide angle, one is on a mid-range, and then one is on a long range, 400 or 200 millimeter. I run three bodies because when I'm shooting racing, there is absolutely no time to change lenses, especially when cars are going by super fast. That way I can have all three ranges all the time ready to go. Okay. The second type of body that we're using pretty much day in and day out is the Canon EOS R5. It's a great mirrorless camera. We use it for video mostly, the fact that it can autofocus at 120 in 4K is absolutely amazing. On top of that, the 45 megapixel stills are so good. I use this for commercial photography as well. It's a great camera overall. The third type of body that I carry with me every single day is the Canon EOS M6 Mark II. The reason why we use this is the form factor. Because we're doing a lot of vlogs for Hoonigan and for my personal channels, this is really small. We can actually film anytime with this. It fits in my pocket, especially with the smaller EFM lenses. This is the 11-22, and this is pretty much the lens that I use on it all the time, just because it's a lot wider and it's great for self-filming and just overall vlogging anytime. Now let's talk about the lenses I have in my bag. This is the workhorse lens. This is perfect for any motorsport photographer. It is the Canon EF 7200 version 3 IS, and it's just the perfect range for shooting cars. It has a pretty wide aperture. It's a 2.8 and it has great image stabilization. We use it for video and stills. You definitely cannot do car photography without this lens. The next lens is something that I use pretty often. It's really lightweight and the bokeh is amazing. It's the Canon EF 135mm f2. It is such a great lens. It's very fast. It just makes some really pleasant looking images. And the reason why mine is all taped up is because we're shooting in the rain, in the dust, in the sand, and we want to try to protect the lens as much as possible. So we just put on some tape. After the event, we take the tape off and it's like brand new again. The next lens that I wanted to talk about is my favorite portraiture lens. It's also a great low light night lens. It is the Canon EF 85mm 1.2 version 2. It is so fast. The front and rear element is huge, but it just makes such a great image and the fall off is just so nice. I always shoot this at 1.2 and I think it's a great addition to any camera bag. The next lens is the Canon EF 1635 f2.8 version 3. I absolutely love using this lens for car-to-car shots, for rolling shots, or anytime we need a wide angle. It is f2.8, which allows me to shoot in lower light conditions. And on top of that, it is an 82mm filter, so this is nice. We can use the same filters that we use for a lot of other lenses, and we can polarize them. It's just a great wide angle lens to have in your bag as a car and motorsport photographer. We just got two more lenses left. This is the Canon EF 2470 version 2. This thing is the commercial monster. We use this anytime we need a tack, 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 tack sharp photo at any focal length from 24 all the way to 70. Plus, on top of that, it is a f2.8, which allows us to use this during low light conditions. We also use this pretty often for video because it's a great video walk around lens and you can zoom in, zoom out to your pleasure. The last lens that I wanted to talk about in my bag is the lens that I use the most often. It is the Canon EF 35mm version 2 1.4. This thing is so fun to use, especially because cars, I feel like, are a certain shape, there's a certain size, and while 50mm is great for everyday walk around shooting, I think the 35 is just a little wider, and with it being 1.4, there's still that separation that I'm always looking for. I can shoot this indoors, outdoors, we can use this for action shots. This is always on one of my bodies, no matter what I'm shooting, no matter where I am. This is definitely the one that I use the most, and I love this lens so much. The last piece of kit that I wanted to talk about is the 1.4 extender. We use this pretty often because anytime we need just a little bit of extra range, we throw this on either the 7200, the 135, or my big boy lenses. Well, that's everything in my main think tank bag, but wait, there's more. I got my big daddy lenses here. We have the Canon EF 200mm f2 IS, and of course, the big daddy, the Canon EF 400mm f2.8 version 3 IS. This thing is so much lighter than the version 1 and 2. Anytime we're shooting motorsports, I'm using this or with the 1.4 extender. It's a great lens and the images are so sharp. This is a game-changing lens, and when I started shooting with glass like this, it really changed the way my images looked. It allowed me to push motorsport photography. This is also a great lens. While I have the 7200, it just doesn't have the separation like the 200 f2 has. When I shoot cars up close or far away, shooting at f2 really separates the car from the background, and this is just such a great hefty lens to pan with and also just freezing action with. Well, that wraps up my kit that I usually bring with me when I'm photographing cars all over the world. If you enjoyed the video, like it. If you want to see more of these, definitely comment below and be sure to subscribe to the Canon USA YouTube channel.